What are you saying, people? Back with a bang. This is the Money Management, back with another video for you guys today. Today is Saturday. On this channel, that means it is the weekend, and the weekend is where winners are made, the weekend is where empires are built. So today's topic is going to be about side hustles and problems with side hustles. Now, the reason I'm talking about this today is because, yes, I have talked about it in the past, but it's an issue, a subject that I need to really reiterate at a point like this, because this is kind of a period of time where a lot of people are trying to make money online, people trying to make a bit extra money for themselves with side hustles through whatever means. And like I said, there are many problems when it comes to side hustles when people are not seeing the returns they want to see, people are not seeing the money, you know, the kind of wins that they want to see, and they end up giving up. Now, I'm going to address all those issues about side hustles in today's video, but before we get into that today, it is the weekend. One thing you guys always have to do on the weekend is give these videos a thumbs up, show you guys enjoyed the video and appreciate my efforts. Also, if you're new around here, please make sure to comment, just let me know, you know, about your channel, let me know what you're about, let me know your thoughts on side hustles. Everybody should be commenting every day, but you guys do a good job of that. We've had a little bit less comments recently, but you know, I'm sure we'll get better, so keep commenting. Also, make sure to hit the red button below if you're new around here. Subscribe to the channel. This is the Money Management. I upload a video each and every day about side hustles, about making money, about finances, about investments, about all sorts of stuff. The Money Management. So check it out. Be here. We've got a load of different videos. Lastly, but most importantly, please make sure you guys are all sharing these videos with your friends. We might have more people, help out more people when it comes to side hustles, their problems with side hustles, making a bit of extra pocket change for themselves, all that stuff. Now, let's dive into today's topic, the problem with side hustles. So like I mentioned, you know, people are really trying to find ways that they can pick up to make a bit of money online, offline, whatever it may be. But there are many different issues when it comes to side hustles. And the first problem I want to talk about when it comes to side hustles is people treat it like a hobby instead of a business. So what do I mean when I say that? Well, people think, you know, they can make money from a side hustle every now and then, you know, when they put in a bit of work, when they try a little bit. That's not how it's gonna work. You know, unless you're someone like Cristiano Ronaldo where you make a lot of money from your side hustle because it's a hobby, you're very rarely gonna get paid like it's a business. You're gonna get paid like it's a hobby. So what exactly do I mean by that? And why do I mention Cristiano Ronaldo? Well, as you guys may or may not know, Cristiano makes more money from Instagram than he does from playing soccer, football, whatever you wanna call it. As you guys know, his job is a footballer. That's what he's known for. But like I said, he makes, I think, around $47 million from Instagram and only 34 or 35 million from football. So effectively, football is a side hustle for him. You know, he's having fun with it. Or if you want to look at it the other way, football is his main job and Instagram is a side hustle, so even better. But we're all not Cristiano Ronaldo, so we're not gonna get paid from businesses if we treat them like hobbies. You have a side hustle, so that means you need to put in hours, that means you put in grind to make it work. We are not in the same position as Cristiano Ronaldo, so we need to treat our businesses like their businesses, not like hobbies. If you treat them like it's a side hustle, like it's not even like very important to you, you're gonna get paid like it's not very important to you. If you treat it like you treat your full-time job, you're gonna get money, you're gonna get returns, you're gonna see how well you do. Last year, as you guys know, I was flipping doorbells at actually this period of time last year, beginning of October, end of September, and I made a lot of money from it on the days that I put in a lot of work, on the days that I really tried to push those doorbells, on the days where I just treated it like a hobby, thought, you know what, I might list it online later, I might message a few people, might get back to some DMs. Well, guess what? I didn't make a lot of money. There were days I made 500, 600 bucks because I really pushed. There were weekends where I didn't really make a lot because I took a step back and I relaxed. People who are suffering when it comes to side hustles are not earning enough, not making enough money because you're treating it like a hobby. If you want to get money from it and actually earn, treat it like a real business. Treat it like you would with your full-time job. Put in the hours, put in the effort, treat it like an actual business. And to be honest, a lot of you guys do suffer when it comes to your side hustle because you like, you know, you enjoy making money, you enjoy your side hustle. But you run into problem number two, which is doing it because of the money, not because of the love of it. So you need to do these side hustles because of your passion for it. Do not start a business for the money, start for the passion. And you know what? We can relate this back to Cristiano Ronaldo. His side hustle, well, he's very passionate about it. So, you know, if that's taking pictures or you say his side hustle is playing with the ball on the field, he does those with passion. That's why he gets paid a lot. Of course, you know, it's not exactly how it works, but I'm saying the fact that he puts in a lot of effort is because he loves it. The fact that he gets a lot of money from it is because he's putting in a lot of effort. And the fact he's putting in a lot of effort comes down to the fact that, like I said, he's doing it with a passion. So for those of you who like making money, well, unfortunately, that cannot be your passion here. You have to enjoy actually doing whatever you do to get money. So whether that's something like me selling smartwatches, which I do enjoy doing, learning about fitness, learning about what kind of things smartwatches can do, or whether that's you just doing something that you've done in the past, doing something that you used to do as a hobby and making money from it. Start your business, start your side hustle, based on your passion. Do not go purely off of money. If you think, oh, I'm gonna get a lot of money because I do this, well, guess what? Eventually, you come to those times where you're suffering, you're not doing well, and you're gonna give up because you're not earning money and you don't enjoy what you do. You did it for the money, now the hard times have come, you're not gonna succeed. You must do these things because you love them. You must do these things because you adore them. You can't just focus on money, unfortunately. I know this is the money management, but I've got to tell you the truth. Passion is what makes it work. You can't do everything based on the idea of money. Passion is the key to making this work. If you rely solely on the aspect of making money, you're gonna fail. It's inevitable. I can tell you guys that. I've done it in the past. Remember, this channel, I tell you guys to learn from my mistakes. So don't purely go off a business idea based on the fact that it can make you a lot of money. Do something you love, do something you enjoy, do something you would do for free. Use that as a side hustle. And not doing it because of passion is something that a lot of people are suffering from, which is why the side hustles are not working. 3, people try to copy instead of being unique. I've experienced this myself. I've seen people try and start a smartwatch company after myself because they thought it would get them a lot of money. If you do try and copy something, don't do it completely how someone else did it. Be unique. So that involves doing it as something you love. That involves hustling even though there's moments you don't want to. The reason that we cannot copy is because we are all different people. We are all different people, that means we are unique. So when it comes to your business ideas, your side hustles, you should also be unique. Do not copy something someone else has done just because it worked. Now I know a lot of people in business do say, you know, especially in entrepreneurship, you must copy different ideas because it's already worked, and if people have already made it work, you can make it work as well. That is definitely the case. We need to tweak a lot of things, which makes it unique. So eventually, even if you do copy an idea, you need to be unique in some form or way. You cannot purely copy someone else's idea and hope that you'll make a lot of money like them. I know lots of people make a lot of money from different things, which I would never be able to do. Even if I do copy it, I would need to still be unique to make it work for myself. Just because it's worked for someone else doesn't mean it will always work for you. Even worse, customers and, you know, people who are eventually going to pay you can spot a fraud. So if you're a fraudulent person, you're not going to get money from it. You absolutely have to be authentic and not just copy. Let's say you're in fitness niche, for example. Someone who's maybe gone from 100 pounds to 180 pounds within 7 months, and they put on a lot of muscle. Or maybe they were that person who found a winning formula and they did certain things and it worked for them. Maybe they had a specific body type which you don't have. Now think about the fact that if you try to do something like that and you've only, let's say, gained 5 pounds is the most you gained in 6-7 months, and you try and copy their model and start selling it to other people, your story's not gonna line up, you're not gonna get the right clients, people are not gonna give you money, you're not gonna be able to answer certain questions, and over you're gonna get called out, you're gonna be exposed, you'll be known as a fraud. That is what you don't want. Don't purely do it because it worked for someone else, they got a lot of money, a lot of clients from it, you know, they're doing that as a full-time job now. You can't be that person. If you want to start something, be authentic. I'm sorry, a lot of you guys out there do listen to other people, do want to be like other people, and eventually try and copy them. Copying is not the way. You can remodel something, you can change things, you can tweak things, but you have to be unique. Authenticity always wins. You guys will learn that as you start, you know, doing things with entrepreneurship, start side hustles. Authenticity is the key. It always wins. So if you're not authentic, you don't do things for yourself, you're not gonna win. Unfortunately, that's just how it is. Don't be someone who copies. Don't be someone who's a sheep, who conforms. Be unique, be your own person. There are tons of you guys out there who are your own person. And if you don't know how to be your own person, just start finding out what you're good at. Start picking out the best things of yourself. Start writing out the best things of yourself. There are tons of you out there who have things that other people don't have. There are tons of you guys who have qualities that I don't have. You can make money in certain ways that I won't be able to. Just because I do something and make money from it does not mean that you guys can also make money from it. I mean, you can try, but if you really want to succeed and want to know one reason why your side hustle may be failing, it's because you're not being unique. Be authentic and be unique instead of copying other people. 4, people think they can get rich quickly. So this is one thing that a lot of people think goes on when it comes to businesses and side hustles. You start today, you make money within a few weeks. After a few weeks, you make more money. Eventually, it's after 6 months, you're making tons of money. That is not always how it works. In fact, let's be honest, that is very rarely how it works. You're not going to get rich quick over one night. You're not going to get rich quick over 6 months. You're not going to get rich quick even over a year. If you want to get rich quickly, if you want to make a lot of money, if you want to become financially free, you're going to have to put in the hours. Very, 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 very few people on this earth get rich quickly without doing the things I just mentioned. And if they do, that means they were lucky. There is a little bit of luck involved at times, but more importantly, you must put in the work. More often than not, you need to put in that grind, put in those hours, put in that time, put in the hours of effort. Yes, there are super lucky people out there, but that's just the way it is. You can't gamble and hope you're going to be one of those people. You must put in the effort I talked about. You have to put in those hours. You have to try your hardest. Everybody has different qualities. Everyone does different things. Everyone does things differently. For those of you out there who do want to know why your side hustle may be failing, you're thinking you can get rich quickly. You're thinking that it's failing when it might not even be failing. You're thinking you're not seeing results when you've been doing it a year. You're thinking it's time to give up after 18 months. You didn't do that with, you know, school, you didn't do that with university, you didn't do that at college, you eventually got your degree. Why do you think when it comes to your side hustle, you can quit so quickly? Don't be that person who thinks you can make a quick buck overnight. That is not what's going to happen with your side hustle. There will be times you really do struggle. I'm telling you from my experiences. Remember, I have a smartwatch company. I know about the struggle. I know about times where you don't make a lot of sales. I know about spending more than you make in a month because you tried really hard, but it just didn't work out. Those things can happen. So that means when it comes to your side hustles, do not think that you can get rich quickly. You don't get rich over one night. Take your time, put in the hours, hone your craft, and eventually the results will come. So overall, those are four different reasons that your side hustle may be suffering and you might not be seeing the results you want to see. I do believe that if you guys do fix these kind of problems, you will see results eventually. Of course, that may not even be the case, but the things I mentioned today are huge reasons why people are suffering and not succeeding. As always, it is the weekend, guys. Go and put some time in your side hustle. Go and start spending some time in your craft. It is your life. You only get one life. You want to live it right. So do what's best now so you can live life best in the long term. As always, please make sure you guys leave me your feedback. Also, check out those links in the description. We've got cryptocurrency, we've got smartwatches, we've got affiliate marketing, we've got an ebook, which is the first link in the description, and we've also got stocks there through Robinhood. Sign up there, you get a free stock, I get a free stock, we both eat. Thanks a lot for watching today's video, guys. That's for today. I've got me to making, we've got side hustle fixing. See you guys tomorrow for another video. Peace.